Question, if you can answer me. I don't know whether you really know the answer to this question, but I want to ask you a question. Who are you? I'm asking a question. I'm saying, who are you?
Ninauliza swali, wewe ni nani?
So this is our subject today. Who are you?
Ili ndilo swali langu kwako, wewe ni nani?
But please don't write who are you, write who am I. If you're writing, you write who am I? Because if we can answer this question, then we are ready for our next. If you can answer this question,
kama unaweza kujibu hili swali,
you are ready for your next.
Uko tayari kwa kiwango kingine.
Your next, I mean your testimony, your blessing, your breakthrough, your everything. So, who are you?
Wewe ni nani?
I'm seeing someone smartly dressed, beautiful, handsome, seated down, you're holding your Bible. But I'm still asking, who are you?
Ninaona mtu ambaye amependeza, ameketi, ameshika Biblia, lakini bado nauliza, wewe ni nani?
Who are you?
Wewe ni nani?
So let's answer this question together.
Basi tujibu kwa pamoja.
One thing that God wants us to deal with as a foundation of what Christianity is the address to this question. Is to address this question. Who we are. Who you are. Who I am. I know if I ask you, you say I'm a Christian. Which is okay.
Najua utasema wewe ni Mkristo na ni sawa pia.
But anyone can say, I'm a Christian.
Lakini yeyote anaweza kusema yeye ni Mkristo.
We need to look deeper inside and ask ourselves this question. Who am I? Who are you?
Tunahitaji kujua kwa undani zaidi na tujiulize, wewe nami ni kina nani?
As it's issue to do with aligning ourselves correctly to the word, make sure we are what the Bible says we are.
Tuhakikishe tuko kama vile Biblia inasema sisi tupo.
Who are you?
Wewe ni nani?
A Christian is one like Jesus.
Mkristo ni kama Yesu.
In the heart is ruled by the word of God.
Kama moyo wake unatawalwa na neno la Mungu.
A Christian is someone that is governed by the scripture.
Mkristo ni yule ambaye anatawaliwa na maandiko.
Is the one who is directed by the scripture, commanded and ruled by the word of God.
Ni yule ambaye anatawaliwa na kuelekezwa na neno.
He lives in the word and the word lives in him.
Ako ndani ya neno na neno lipo ndani yake.
He walks with God.
Anatembea na Mungu.
He lives in God.
Anaishi na Mungu.
And God lives in him.
Na Mungu anaishi ndani yake.
This is a Christian.
Huyu ndiye Mkristo.
My question this morning, who are you?
Swali langu asubuhi ya leo.
What am I really looking for? I'm looking to find out whether you have relationship with Jesus.
Ninacho kitafuta ni kujua ya kwamba wewe uko na uhusiano na Mungu.
Because let us agree, brethren, anyone can say I'm a Christian, anyone can say I go to church, anyone can say I love God. But do you have a relationship with Jesus?
Yeyote yule anaweza kusema mimi ni Mkristo, ninaenda kanisani, lakini uko na uhusiano na Yesu Kristo?
Say after me. Who I am is same as asking myself, do I have relationship with Jesus? So when I ask you, who are you? I'm expecting you to check inside your heart and look to see whether you have relationship, you have fellowship with Jesus.
Ninapokuuliza wewe ni nani, ninatarajia uchunguze moyo wako na uone kama uko na mahusiano na Yesu Kristo.
This time not talking, I'm not speaking about talking that I'm a Christian, I go to church, I read the Bible. No. Look inside your hearts. Is there relationship or fellowship between your spirit, your heart, and the word of God?
Sio kwa mazungumzo, sio kwa kunena, lakini uchunguze moyo wako uone kama una mahusiano na Yesu Kristo.
Because, brethren, I repeat my message again. Some of the things you are looking for from God, you will not receive them by praying alone, but by having a strong relationship with Jesus.
Baadhi ya mambo unayoyatafuta kutoka kwa Mungu, hautayapokea tu kwa kuomba, lakini kwa kupitia ushirika wako na Mungu.
Please preach to your neighbor. Tell your neighbor, these things you are asking for. Okay, let us go together. Let us go together. Tell your neighbor, these things you are asking for.
These things you are asking for.
You may not receive by praying alone. But for you to receive, you must have a strong, true, exchange this microphone. You get me? Some of the standard we want, life we are looking for in God, sister, you will not get it only by praying. It will demand a strong, true relationship with Jesus.
Baadhi ya viwango ambavyo tunavitafuta ndani ya Kristo, hatutapipata tu kwa sababu ya maombi, lakini kupitia kwa mahusiano yetu ya ukweli na Yesu Kristo.
Tell your neighbor, what you are dreaming right now, where you want to go, what you want to receive, is not by prayer alone, but by a strong, true relationship with Jesus. You mark my words. Strong and true. Strong means si ile na yumba yumba kila siku. Today Jesus, tomorrow this. Tomorrow Jesus, tomorrow this. No. Strong relationship. True means genuine, based and founded in the word of Jesus.
Mahusiano ya uthabiti na ukweli ambayo yanatokana na neno la Mungu.
Let me ask you.
Acha niulize.
Zaidi ya kukiri na kinywa chako kusema umeokoka, nionyeshe kitu ingine kwa maisha yako ambayo inaonyesha uko na uhusiano na Yesu Kristo. Wacha kusema nimeokoka, wacha kwenda kanisa, wacha kuomba. Show me something else that can tell me you have a relationship with Jesus.
Nionyeshe kitu kingine kwa maisha yako ambacho kinadhibitisha uko na mahusiano na Yesu Kristo.
I'll draw your attention to John 21 verse 15. When Jesus wanted to assign Peter assignment, Jesus asked Peter, "Peter, do you love me more than this? Do you love me more than this?"
Unanipenda zaidi ya hii.
John 21 from verse 15. What Jesus was looking for in Peter was he wanted to know whether Peter has a relationship with him.
Kile ambacho Yesu alitaka kujua kutoka kwa Petro ni kujua kwamba alikuwa na mahusiano naye.
Do you love me more than this? In short, do you have a relationship with me?
Je, uko na mahusiano nami?
Wacha kando, tunatembea na wewe pamoja, tunakula pamoja, tunafanya mambo pamoja. Wacha hiyo. Personally, wewe, je, uko na uhusiano na Yesu? Hivyo ndivyo Yesu alikuwa anauliza Petero. Do you have a relationship?
Je, uko na uhusiano na mimi?
Because what Jesus was about to give Peter was ministry, unique. So, before some unique blessings are given to us, God will demand to see relationship. Not talking. Strong, true relationship.
Kabla ya baraka zingine kuachiliwa kwetu, Mungu atachunguza kujua kama tuko na uhusiano thabiti naye.
Say after me, strong, true relationship. God does not judge like we judge.
Mungu ahukumu vile tunavyohukumu.
You know, man will look at you and judge you by the way you are dressed, what you can do. But God will not look at that. No. God will look at your heart and determine whether there is fellowship, there is relationship in the spirit.
Mungu atauchunguza moyo wako na ajue kama kuna mahusiano kati yako naye.
In other words, you look in your heart to see is your heart ruled by the word.
Atachunguza moyo wako na atajua
can
Can the scriptures direct you, correct you, rebuke you, sharpen you? Can the scripture do that? This is what we mean by relationship. Does the word rule your decision?
Je, neno linaongoza maamuzi yako?
Does your word, the word of God, can the scriptures tell you what to do and what not to do?
Je, neno linaweza kukuelekeza?
Angalia story ya Petero. Amefua samaki, hajapika kitu. Asubuhi imefika, anataka kuenda. Yesu anakuja anasema, sasa rudisha hapo tena. Petero anasema, mimi nilikuwa nime give up. Lakini kwa sababu umesema, tarudisha. Hiyo ni ishara ya mtu ambaye aishi kwa sababu ya maneno yake ama decision yake. Anaishi kwa sababu ya uamuzi unaotoka kwa neno ya Mungu. So this is what I'm asking. Who are you?
Hii ndio ninauliza.
The answer to this should be, I am in fellowship. I am connected to God.
Niko na mahusiano na nimeunganika na
Mungu. So when I ask you who you are, tell me, I am connected to God. Who are you?
I am connected to God.
Who are you? I can't hear your voice. Louder. Who are you? And this connection is not talking. No. In the heart, in the spirit, where people will see your actions, but the fellowship is eaten in the spirit.
Mahusiano yamefichika ndani ya roho yako.
I have a strong link with God.
Niko,
I am in communication, in union with Jesus. I am connected to God.
Niko na mahusiano thabiti na Mungu.
So who are you?
I am connected to God.
Who are you?
Okay, if you say you are connected to God, show me that connection.
Ukisema umeunganika na Mungu, basi nionyeshe ayo
mungu. The best way to show this communication, this connection, is to examine your heart, your action and everything, and tell me, are you ruled, controlled, directed by the scripture?
Njia halisi ya kuonyesha kwamba una mahusiano na Mungu ni kuchunguza moyo wako na uniambie kama unatawaliwa na neno.
To your neighbor, you are telling me, talk to your neighbor, you are telling me you are connected to God.
You are connected to God.
Show me.
Prove to me
whether
you are ruled.
You are guided. And you are directed by the word of Jesus. Si uniona si kuongea peke yake, si kukiri, lakini ni kuonyesha. Nyuma yako kuna matendo unaweza onyesha ukasema ile ni Mungu tu. Alisema na akisema hakuna wa kupinga. I have to do it. Nilikuwa nataka kwenda hivi, akasema hivi. I have to go that direction. I was feeling like I don't want, lakini anaposema I want it. I want what God wants. I want it for the reason God wants it.
Ninataka kile Mungu anataka kwa sababu amekitaka.
Those that are ruled by the word of God,
wale ambao wanataliwa na neno la Bwana,
their desire, their movement is Christ's movement. Their yes is Christ's yes.
Ndio yao ni ndio ya
Kristo. Jesus says no is their no.
Hapana kwa Yesu ni hapana kwao.
So who are you?
Je, wewe ni nani?
Who are you? How can you show that connection? My heart is ruled, directed by the word of God.
Moyo wangu unatawaliwa na kuelekezwa na neno.
Don't just talk, but show that when Jesus say forgive, I forgive immediately. When Jesus say laugh, you laugh. When Jesus say sit down, you sit down. When Jesus say stand, you stand.
Usiseme tu lakini onyesha.
It's not just talking, no. It must be seen in action. Tell your neighbor, it's not just talking. It must be seen in action.
See,
Jesus says no, it's your no. Jesus says yes, it's your yes. Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary, pure and holy, tried and true, sought to with thanksgiving. I'll be a sanctuary for you. Who are you? Who are you? Can you show that connection? How? My heart, my actions, my speech is ruled, governed, directed by the word of God.
Moyo wangu na maisha yangu yanataliwa na neno la Bwana.
Now, forget about your pastor. Forget about your church. Forget about your brothers and sisters. Personally, do you have a relationship with Jesus?
Kando na kanisa na mchungaji wako. Je, wewe uko na
uhusiano? Forget your pastor. Come on. Forget your neighbor. Forget your church. Whatever name you call your church. My question is, personally, do you have relationship with Jesus?
Wewe binafsi, uko na mahusiano na Yesu Kristo?
Somebody talk to me. Because kuna siku, kanisa itakuwa. Kuna siku, jirani yako, mnaenda church naye atakuwa. Kuna siku, hakuna mtu atakuwa karibu na wewe wa kukuencourage. Relationship ambayo umejenga na Mungu, ndio itakutetea. Ndio itakusimamisha. Ndio itakupeleka kiwango kingine. Do you have relationship with Jesus?
Je, uko na uhusiano na Yesu Kristo?
In other words, who are you?
Wewe ni nani?
Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Before anything, brothers and sisters, at every given point in time, always ask yourself this question. Am I connected to Jesus? Repeat again. At every given time, always ask yourself that question. Before Peter start ministry, Jesus wants to know, is there a relationship? In the book of Luke 10, 17 to 20, if I can read. Luke 10, 17 to 20. When Jesus sent the 70 to go and minister, they came back with a report, and the Bible says in verse number 17, the 70 returned with joy, saying, Lord, even the demons are subject to us in your name. And he said to them, I saw Satan fall like lightning from heaven. Behold, I give you the authority to trample on serpents
and scorpion, and over all the power of enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. Look at verse 20. Nevertheless, do not rejoice in this, that the spirits are subject to you, but rather rejoice because your names are written in heaven.
Ndipo wale sabini waliporudi.
Soma mstari wa 20 pekee.
Lakini msifurahi kwa vile pepo wanavyowatii, bali furahini kwa sababu majina yenu yameandikwa mbinguni.
Look here. Before is their relationship. After is their relationship. You see? Jesus asked Peter before the ministry. After the 70 have done the ministry, when they come back, Jesus still want to know, is there a relationship?
Yesu bado anataka kujua kama kuna mahusiano.
Are you getting me?
Je, unanipata?
This is what matters more to Jesus. Connection, link with God.
Cha muhimu sana kwa Yesu ni mahusiano.
If I'm talking to somebody, can I hear amen? When they were happy, all demons were running away, screaming, here and there. Jesus said, okay, that's okay. But, gentlemen, the thing that should make you joy the more is relationship with God.
Kile ambacho kinatakiwa kufurahisha zaidi ni uhusiano wako na Mungu.
Sometimes it's not even what we do.
Wakati mwingine sio vile tunafanya.
You know, sometimes God may not look as much as what you do. More, he will look at who you are. Who you are. Because this is what will determine on the last day. Whether uliubiria watu wengi, ulifukuza mapepo, ulienda kanisa, ulifanya hii, ukafanya hii. Ile kitu itasimama siku ya mwisho, ni kama una connection na nani? Na Mungu. This is what matter. Before you come to church, ask yourself, is there a connection? When you are seated down here, is there a connection? When we say the grace, you are walking back to your house, is there a connection? Because Jesus can come in time.
Kabla ujakuja kanisani na hata baada ya kutoka, jiulize kama una mahusiano na Yesu.
Will you be ready when the Lord shall come? Siku itafika na sisi wote tutaondolewa na tutasimama mbele yake na kila mtu atatoa hesabu ya maisha yake. Wale walikuwa na uhusiano na Mungu, karibuni katika ufalme wa Bwana. Wale hawakuwa na uhusiano na Mungu, hata kama ulifanya nini na moyo wako haukutawaliwa na neno, the other side inakungojea. That's why Yesu anasema, I don't care whether demons obey you or not. What I care is, gentlemen, are you connected to heaven?
Je, umeunganika na mbingu?
Rich or poor, the question is, are you connected to heaven?
Uwe ni maskini ama tajiri, swali ni.
God is God of both poor and rich.
Kwa sababu Mungu ni Mungu wa wote.
Being poor does not mean you don't belong to God.
Kukuwa maskini haimaanishi wewe si wa Mungu.
Are you connected?
Je, umeunganika?
Who are you?
Wewe ni nani?
When you look at 1 Samuel 16. Let us go there. 1 Samuel 16. Look at what God is saying. Verse 7. You can read the whole chapter at your own time. When God sent Samuel to anoint David and the sons of, is it Eli, were passing by. When you read from verse 1, it tells you about Samuel anointing King David. So Eliab was there, brother to David. Alikuja akapita mbele ya Samuel. Na Samuel anafikiria mafuta itamwagika kwa Eliab kwa sababu Eliab alikuwa mtu mkubwa na nguvu, stamina ya mwili. Abinada verse 18. Pia na yeye akapitia mbele ya Samuel. Samuel anafikiri mfalme ndio huyu amechaguliwa. Bila alikuwa amevaa smart, ako strong na muscles, ataweza kuokoa Israeli. Jesse akaleta Shama pia akapita na watoto wake wote wa Jesse wakapita mbele ya Samuel. Lakini Mungu alikataa Samuel akimwaga mafuta. Paka Samuel akauliza, watoto wote wamepita mbele yangu, je, hakuna mwingine? Akasema kuna kamoja kule kwa msitu, kazi yake ni kulinda kondoo, lakini wale wazuri smart wako hapa. Samueli akasema hatutasimama mpaka huyo kijana aletwe hapa. Na alipofika, maandiko nasema he was looking rudy, yani alikuwa anakaa hivyo tu kuchakaa, ananuka mbuzi na kondoo. Imagine Mungu anamwambia Samueli, inuka mtumishi wangu. I like the scripture. The Bible says, verse number 12. So he sent and brought him. Now he was ruddy, with bright eyes and looking good. And the Lord said, arise, anoint him, for this is the one. Hallelujah! Samuel akachanganyikiwa. Aya, Mungu ameacha wale wamevaa smart, those who are, they look strong, is going for bushman, cattle keeper. Mungu anamwambia, verse number 7, the Lord said to Samuel, do not look at his appearance. Sasa ni wale wa kwanza walipita, wale wakubwa, or the physical stature, because I have refused them. For the Lord does not see as man see. For man looks at the outside appearance, but the Lord looks at the heart. I like this. Man looks outside, but Jesus looks inside.
Mwanadamu anatazama nje, lakini Mungu utazama ndani.
He looks at relationship. Is there connection?
Anaangalia mahusiano.
Not just how you look like, what you do, this and that. No. He looks at those who have connection with Jesus.
Sio vile ulivyo, mbali
those that are controlled, ruled, and directed by the scripture.
wale ambao wanatawaliwa na kuelekezwa
na neno, not their feelings, not their emotions, not what they want, but what heavens wants.
Sio vile wanataka lakini vile mbingu
inataka. These are the children of God.
Hawa ndio watoto wa Mungu.
Who are you?
Wewe ni nani?
Who are you?
Wewe ni nani?
Who are you?
I am connected to God.
Who are you?
I am connected to God.
Can you show that connection? How? My heart, my actions, my speech is ruled, guided, directed by the scripture. What Jesus wants is what I want. And I want it for the reason he wants it.
Kile Yesu anataka ndicho ninachokitaka na ninakitaka kwa sababu anataka.
Look at the world today.
Angalia ulimwengu wa leo.
Confusion all over the world.
Kuchanganyikiwa kila mahali.
When you go to institutions anywhere, when they are trying to employ people, get men for work, they look at papers.
Wanatazama makaratasi.
Your qualification, which school you are, how many experience you have, how are you dressed, you are talking, your speech. They forget to look at the character of this man, this lady.
Wanasahau kutazama tabia ya mtu huyu.
We don't look at the inside, we look at the outside.
Atutazami ndani, tunatazama nje.
We look at what this person can do to us.
Natazama kile ambacho mtu anaweza kutufanyia.
That is the nature of the world.
Hivyo ndivyo ilivyo.
And that's why there is failure all over the world.
Ndio maana kuna kuchanganyikiwa kwingi ulimwenguni.
They will not want to know whether you have link with God.
Wanataka kujua kama una mahusiano na
Mungu. No, what can you do for us?
Lakini wanataka kujua unaweza.
That's why there is failure all over the world. Institutions are falling down, governments are falling down, because we employ wrong people just because of what they can do for us, but without looking at their personality. All over the world. When it comes to God, sometimes he doesn't care what you can do or what you are able to do. He cares about, do you have relationship with him?
Ikifika ni kwa Mungu, ana haja
about what you can do, you leave it to him. He will sort it out. Because he raises the weak and gives them grace. Do even what the strong cannot do. God chooses the weak and the isolated, those with connection with him, rather than going for those that seem to know what to do. But he gives them grace, empowers them, and works through them to work signs and wonders.
Amen.
But when you go to the world, look at the world today, they want to know, what can you do for us?
Naweza kufanya nini?
What is your qualification?
Umehitimu kufanya nini?
Can you speak fluently?
Unaweza kuzungumza?
Do you know how to do this, how to do this? They forget.
Wanasahau tabia.
The hina of the man.
Undani wa mtu.
Don't be like them. Say after me, I am the world. Say after me, I am in the world, but not of the world. When they are looking outside, I will look inside, like my Father. Thank you, Jesus. So when it comes to you and you're looking for a business partner, you're looking for a husband, for a wife, you're looking for this and that, please, the Bible warns us. We are not concerned about what these people can do to us. What concerns us more should be their link with God. What should concern us more is what God is saying about their character. Those who cannot know their character, Holy Spirit is there to help us know the character of this man, the character of this, the personality of this person. Who are you?
Wewe ni nani?
Eh?
Connect.
Eh? Can you show it? Yes. How? My heart, my action, my speech, my action are ruled, governed, directed by the scripture. That is who you are. Look at the problem you are facing today. That is it. People don't want to look at the inside. They just want to look outside.
Watu wanataka tu kutazama nje.
That's why you are crying every day, because you follow the same example. No one is asking God, please Lord, tell me, who is this person?
Hakuna mtu anamwambia Mungu, Mungu nionyeshe huyu mtu ni nani.
When you meet them, please desire to know, who is this?
Ukikutana nao tamani sana kuwajua.
Wherever you go, please ask yourself, who am I?
Popote unaenda, jiulize wewe ni nani.
May the Holy Spirit help you to know.
Roho wa Mungu atusaidie kujua.
The real answer in Jesus' name. God has given us his word.
Mungu ametupa neno lake.
We should follow the example in the Bible.
Tunatakiwa kufuata tabia ya neno.
What you need to do? Work on your relationship with God.
Fanyia kazi mahusiano yako na Mungu.
God will work out what you can do through his word.
Mungu atashughulika kile ambacho unatakiwa kufanya kupitia kwa neno lake.
Those who want to serve God.
Wale wanatamani kumtumikia Mungu.
I'm talking to you. Can you say amen? Those who want to serve God.
Wale wanataka kumtumikia
Mungu. What do you need to do? Work on your relationship with Jesus first. Then Jesus will work out what you can do through his words.
Fanyia kazi mahusiano yako na Mungu.
If I'm talking, can I hear amen? Can I repeat again? Work out your relationship with Jesus. Then Jesus Christ will work out what you can do through his words. Hata sasa ile unataka kutumikia Mungu sana, usijisumbue. No. Just work out your relationship with God. Go himself will pick you out and say, this is my son. Listen to him. Sometimes I see people fighting for leadership in church, for ministry. I want to pray. I want to be pastor. I want to be... Hello, these people. If you could know the secret is what? Work out your relationship with Jesus. Jesus will pick you out of many people and present you to the world. You don't need to fight your way. The best way to fight your way through is to fight for your relationship with Jesus. Not what you can do, but who you are. Work out on who you are. Jesus will work out what you can do and to what extent you will do it. In Jesus' name we pray. Look here. The Bible gives us the lowest limit of what we can do. Relationship with Jesus determines the height we can go, the wide we can spread to the glory of God. Hallelujah. Those that are ruled by the word of God.
Wale ambao wanatawaliwa na neno la Bwana.
What is written here?
Kile ambacho kimeandikwa.
Is only the lowest standard.
Ni kiwango cha chini tu.
Their relationship with Jesus day by day.
Mahusiano yao na Yesu.
Is what determines the height they can go and the wider they can spread. Am I talking to you?
Yes.
So wale watu wako na link na Mungu, neno ikisema 10 ama 5, utawakuta kwa 5 ama 10? No, utawakuta kwa 80%, na utawakuta kwa, kama inasema 100 pande, utawakuta kwa 300 na uko wakiendanga. Meaning maandiko inawacholea tu ile lowest limit, standard ya chini. Maana wako na uhusiano na Mungu, wakiingia hapo kwa sababu ya uhusiano lio na Mungu, hata kaa kwa hiyo kiwango imesemwa hapa, ataenda juu na wide, because this person is connected to Jesus. Lakini those who are not connected, even the lowest limit here, they cannot reach. They cannot reach. It tells you are not connected. If you can't reach the lowest limits written in this Bible, it tells you are not connected.
Kama uwezi kufikia hata kiwango kilichoandikwa kwa neno, inamaanisha haujaunganishwa.
That's why I'm asking you today, who are you?
Ndio maana ninakuuliza leo, wewe ni nani?
You need to work on your relationship.
Unahitaji kufanyia kazi mahusiano yako.
If you want to know you are connected to God,
ama unataka kujua
umeunganishwa, how will you know?
Utajuaje?
You realize that whatever is written in this Bible to you is the lowest limit you can go. But your relationship with Him will work out wider and higher than what is written here, because of the relationship you keep with Jesus. Glory to God. Are you connected? Do you think you have a connection?
Unafikiria uko na mahusiano?
Na unashindwa kufikia lowest limit ya maandiko. Unashindwa. You have no connection. And the last day is coming. The last day is coming. Na hujafikia limit, lowest limit in the scripture. That's why the Bible say, wale wanamjua Mungu wao. Inamaanisha wale wako na connection. Yeah? Watafanya aje? Watakuwa strong. Na watafanya nini? Come on. Amasamagi maandiko. Those that know their God will be strong. And they will do what?
Exploits.
They will do what?
Exploits.
Now, hizo exploits, diyo nakwambia, inadetaminiwa na relationship ya Mkristo katika Mungu. Ile umbali ataenda katika neno, na wider bidi ataenda katika neno. Si mtu wa kitu moja every day. No. Maandiko isema, ikisema, ombeni kila siku. Ye hata omba, as in, omba asubuhi, mchana, jioni. Ye anaomba all the time. Funga na kuomba. It's like all the time. Samea mara hii. Ye hata samea mara hiyo, hata samea all the time. Because relationship yake, itamurusu, itamusukuma upate every day. Anarepeat kile Mungu alisema. Without compromise. Simama tuombe.